First, let's create the background or the backdrop object for our rendering. We're going to add cornerless white stage. To do that, let's create this giant cylinder. Name it backdrop. Place it at the origin. Set the radius to 400 cm. Height to 400 cm also. Height segments to 4, cap segments to 2, and the sides to 18. Okay, now convert the object to an editable poly object. Go to the top viewport and select these vertices and then delete them. Next, apply normal modifier. This will flip the surface and make it facing inside. Convert it again to editable poly. Go to the border mode and select this border. Hold shift and drag so we have extended surfaces to cover the chair. Now turn on norms and set the iteration to 2. Create a new corona material. Set the color value to 100. Then assign it to the backdrop object. Next, we're going to create the ambient light, key lights, and then the backlight. If you don't have any clue what are these lights are for, just to make things simple, basically ambient light serve as the base environment light that usually coming from every direction. The key lights is the main light sources, and the backlight is used for defining the object silhouette so it doesn't eat up by darkness. Okay, now if we hit the render button, we see nothing. Corona will not add any standard lighting if there are no light whatsoever in the scene. To add ambient light to our scene, we're going to use simple environment light. To do that, go to render setup window, go to scene, then in the scene environment section, choose this corona and set this to light bluish color. Now when we hit render, we can start seeing our objects in the scene. Of course, the lighting is still dull. Next, we will add a key light by creating a corona light into the scene. The main purpose of this light is to kill the uniformity of the ambient light, making the light from the top source stronger. To do that, go to the Create panel, Light, Corona Light, and just click and drag in the viewport. Go to Modify panel and change the light shape to disc. Set the radius to 100. And put it on top, almost touching the upper ceiling, and position it slightly forward. I'm going to use a coordinate of x 0, y minus 30 cm, and z to 330 cm. Change the intensity to 5, then turn off visible directly and occlude other light. This visible directly option, if turned off, will make the light shape invisible in the rendering. And the occlude other light option, if turned off, will make the shape of the light not casting shadow from other lights into the scene. Next, let's create another key light from the side. Now, the main purpose of this light is to create nice specular in the leather and metal materials of our chair object. To create it, just copy this light. Move it slightly to the left area. If you want to follow my coordinates exactly, I use the coordinate of x minus 300 cm, y minus 30 cm, and z 160 cm. Change the intensity to 20. Change the color to slightly yellow. I'm using hue 25, saturation 80, and value to 255. Now, for this light, I want it to face the object. We can do that easily by turning this targeted checkbox in here, and this will create a target object. To select the target object, just right-click and choose Select Light Target, then move the target to the origin. Notice how the corona light will always facing the target position. For the backlight, just copy the key light to this position. For the coordinates, I will use x 200 cm, y 140 cm, and z to 60 cm. Change the intensity to 120. Then change the color to hue 160, saturation to 230, and value to 230 also. Change the light shape to rectangle, so later we have variation in the light reflection appears in the metal area. Change the width to 50 and height to 100 cm. Before we render, just clone instant this chair. And rotate it like so. Place it in this position. This is so people can see how the chair looks like from side. Okay, now let's change our rendering resolution. I will change the width to 1280 pixels and the height to 720 pixels. Basically, it's a 720p HD resolution. Hit the render button and just wait. Corona will keep rendering and refining the image. Until you are satisfied with the quality of the rendering, you can stop the rendering and hit this save button later to save the rendering to an image file. Okay guys, we finally finished this tutorial series. If you like my tutorial, don't forget to subscribe to get updates to my other future tutorials. And if you think my tutorials is a bit hard to follow, this may be because the tutorial was intended for intermediate users. If you want to learn 3ds Max from the beginning, I provide a good 3ds Max course for complete beginners at Udemy. And because you watch this video from start to finish, as a token of my gratitude, I will provide you with this special link with 75% discount worth of $150. Just follow this link and it will automatically redeem a discount coupon for you. This Udemy course consists of more than 70 high quality videos that will teach you from basic stuff like navigating through viewport, modeling, lighting, rendering, up until you can create image similar like this one. Again, this link only available for those who watch this video. And it does have limited slots, so be sure to use it before it runs out. Thanks again for watching, and I hope this tutorial is beneficial for you. Wassalamualaikum.